JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for February the 26th. I am Charalambos, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It gained the most versus NOK, AUD, GBP and NZD in that order, while it decked out the least gains against JPY and the euro. The greenback was found virtually unchanged versus the Swiss franc. The relative strength of the safe havens franc and yen and the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi suggest that markets turned risk off yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that most major EU indices closed slightly in the negative territory, with risk aversion intensifying during the US and the Asian sessions. The driver behind the rebound in equities was once again rising bond yields due to heightening inflation expectations. It is worth noting that the bond sell-off accelerated after a disappointing auction of seven-year US notes, with the 10-year yields surging more than 20 basis points to hit a fresh one-year high above 1.6%. All this suggests that despite Fed Chair Powell's reassurance that he and his colleagues will keep monetary policy accommodative until there is substantial improvement towards their employment and inflation goals, market participants remained unconvinced and still worried that the economic recovery will lead to high inflation. Recently, we've been highlighting that the unprecedented government and monetary policy stimulus combined with the increasing COVID vaccinations may allow equities to trend north and safe havens to stay under selling interest on expectations that the global economic recovery is on track. It now seems we've reached a point where the same catalysts have a different market effect. Yes, investors still believe to a strong economic rebound, but they are now afraid that this would lead to higher inflation. In any case, we still believe that the slide in equities and other risk-linked assets will prove to be a corrective phase, and the reason is that the Fed has noted that they will not tighten policy even if inflation overshoots 2% in the months to come. They clearly said that they expect such a spike to be temporary and that inflation will rise and stay above 2% for some time, the goal for the beginning of normalization, in the years after 2023. As a result, we expect fears over high inflation to ease in the foreseeable future, which may allow equities and other risk-linked assets to rebound. As for the dollar, it may come under selling interest or more signs that the Fed is likely to stay accommodative for longer than previously assumed. Now, as for today's events, during the US session, we get personal income and spending data for January alongside the core PCE index for the month. Personal income is expected to have surged 9.9% month over month after rising 0.6% in December, while spending is anticipated to have rebounded 2.5% month over month after sliding 0.2%. The core PCE index is expected to have ticked down to 1.4% year over year from 1.5%. A slide in this inflation metric, which is the Fed's favorite one, may ease somewhat concerns over high inflation and thereby allow the equities to rebound. At the same time, the US dollar may pull back. The final University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for February is also coming out, and the forecast is for a small upside revision to 76.5 from 76.2. As for the speakers, we have three on today's agenda, and those are Bank of England Chief Economist Andy Haldane, Bank of England Deputy Governor for Markets and Banking and Dave Ramsden, and ECB Executive Board Member Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a great weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.